Mother Frost. A widow and her two daughters lived near a spring at the edge of a forest. One of the daughters was a beautiful, kind soul who helped her mother around the house as much as she could. The other daughter was ugly, both inside and out. She was lazy and never lifted so much as a finger to help her mother. Despite this, the mother loved the lazy, ugly daughter because she was her own child. The kind, beautiful girl was her stepdaughter, and the mother did not care for her at all. She would give her all of the hard tasks to do around the house. Every day the young girl would sit at the spinning wheel by the well and spin until her fingers were sore and bleeding. One day, the girl was washing her hands in the well when she dropped one of the spindles into the water and it fell to the bottom. She had tears in her eyes as she ran, nervously, to tell her stepmother what had happened. "Stupid girl," barked the stepmother angrily. "Now that you have dropped the spindle into the water, then you shall go in and get it out again." The little girl went back to the well. Her stepmother had made her so nervous that she didn't know what to do. Without thinking, she leaned over the well. Though she leaned too far and found herself tumbling head first down the well. She closed her eyes as she tumbled to the bottom. When she opened them again, she was surprised to find herself in a meadow full of flowers. The sun was shining brightly. The little girl walked across the meadow of flowers and came to a bakery. The big ovens were full of loaves of bread, and they called out to the little girl, "Pull us out of the oven, please. Pull us out. We have been baked for long enough, and if you don't take us out, we will burn." "Of course," cried the sweet young girl. She took the oven gloves and pulled out the tray of loaves from the oven immediately. She carried on walking and came across an apple tree. The tree's branches were loaded with ripe apples, their weight pulling the branches downwards. "Shake me," cried the tree. "My apples are ripe and ready to be picked." "I will," answered the girl, and she began to shake the tree vigorously. The apples began to rain down to the ground, and she didn't stop shaking until there was not a single apple left on the tree. Then she gathered them together into a heap and walked on. At last, she came across a little cottage. In the doorway sat an old woman with teeth so large that the girl was frightened and turned to run away. The old woman called out to her, "Don't be afraid, child. Come and live here in my little cottage and take care of me. I promise that if you help around the house, then I will be kind to you. Although, please make sure to make my bed well. You must shake it well so that the feathers fly about. That way all of the children will see them and say that snowflakes are falling, for I am old Mother Frost." The old woman spoke so kindly that the young girl immediately felt at ease. "I will happily work for you," she told the old woman. The girl was a hard worker, and each day she did her chores to perfection. She remembered what the old lady had told her about the bed, and each day she shook it so well that the flowers flew around like snowflakes. She was very happy with Mother Frost, who always spoke kindly to her and treated her well. After some time, though, she began to feel homesick. She could not help it, despite her life living with Mother Frost being a happy one. She decided to speak to Mother Frost about how she was feeling. "Dear Mother Frost," she began, "you have been so very kind to me, but I miss my friends. I would like to go home now and see them." "Of course, my dear," replied the old woman. "And as you have been so kind to me, I will show you the way myself." With that, she took the girl by the hand and led her to a great door which she opened. As the girl stepped through the doorway, a shower of gold came down and fell all around her. The gold stuck to her clothes so that she was covered in gold from her head down to her feet. "That is your payment for working so hard," said the old woman. And here is your spindle that fell into the well," she added, handing it over to the young girl. The door then closed suddenly, and the girl found herself once more upon the earth, not far from her mother's house. As she came into the courtyard, the cockerel sat up and began to sing, "Cock-a-doodle-doo! Our golden lady has come home too!" The girl went into the house, and upon seeing all of the gold, the stepmother was extremely kind to her. The young girl told her the story of falling down the well, meeting the old lady, and how she came to receive the gold. The stepmother could not wait for her own daughter to try the same thing. So this time, she sent her own daughter down by the well to spin thread. But the girl was so lazy that she didn't spin fast enough to make her fingers bleed. So she pricked her finger on a thorn to get a drop of blood, and she wiped it on the spindle. Then she purposely let the spindle fall into the well and jumped in after it. She fell down and down before finding herself in a beautiful meadow, just as her stepsister had. She walked along the same path to the bakery. She heard the loaves shout, pull us out, or we will burn." "I will not," snorted the girl. "Your oven is too dirty." She continued on until she came to the apple tree. Shake me," cried the tree. "My apples are ripe for picking." "No chance," retorted the girl. "Some of your apples might fall on my head." She ambled along lazily. She soon stood in front of Mother Frost's house. Remembering what had happened to her stepsister, she had no fear of the old woman with the big teeth and walked straight up to her, offering to be her assistant. The girl was busy for a whole day. She did everything that Mother Frost asked her to. However, by the second day, she started to slow down and get lazy. By the third day, she was even worse. She would sleep late in the mornings and would never make the old woman's bed properly. She didn't shake it so that the feathers flew about. Mother Frost soon tired of the lazy girl and told her to go home. This was exactly what the girl wanted. She wanted to be taken to the great door and have the shower of gold fall down and cover her. Mother Frost led the child to the door. But as the girl passed through it, a tub of sticky black tar came raining down on top of her. "That is what you get for your work," said the old woman. The girl walked home covered in tar. When she got to the courtyard, the cockerel crowed, "Cock-a-doodle-doo! Our sticky lady has come home too!" The tar was stuck so fast to the girl that for as long as she lived, she never managed to get it off again.